Willis Casey's swimming career ended during a teenage bout with tuberculosis. But that didn't prevent the Goldsboro, North Carolina native from becoming one of the biggest contributors in the history of collegiate athletics. As a successful coach, as a barrier-breaking administrator, and as a television pioneer. He not only produced Olympic, NCAA, AAU, Atlantic Coast Conference, and Southern Conference champions as a well-decorated swimming coach, he made it possible for other coaches to do the same as pioneering leader during the golden age of Wolfpack athletics.
Mr. Casey was brilliant. He was one of the smartest people I've ever been around, particularly with numbers. And he never forgot anything. He had a tremendous memory.
He loved NC State. He'd do anything to win. And he would give you, like I said, everything you needed to have to win. Not anymore. but he expected results. And to tell you the truth, I love the guy.
Willis should be remembered as the godfather of Wolfpack athletics.
Overall, his teams won 11 conference championships and 4 AAU national titles. He coached multiple Olympians, 4 individual NCAA champions, 9 individual AAU champions, and 33 All-Americans. His full-time move into athletics administration in 1969 is where Casey made his biggest impact. From 1969 to 1986, Casey ran a small athletics department on a shoestring budget, yet his programs won 2 NCAA men's basketball championships, 2 AIAW women's cross-country national titles, and more than a dozen titles in football, basketball, and baseball, along with dozens and dozens more in Olympic sports. And he paid off the cumbersome bond on Carter Finley Stadium some 28 years early in 1979, enabling an expansion of the department's general operating budget.
It really accelerated everything here at NC State. If you go back and look, like I said, the basketball program, the football program, a lot of the non-revenue sports start to really climb.
List of coaches he hired here, you would see a Hall of Fame group of people that at one time or another led a sports program here at NC State.
He hired football coaches Lou Holtz, Bo Rein, and Dick Sheridan. He hired basketball coaches Valvano and Yao, baseball's Ray Tanner, golf's Richard Sykes, wrestling's Bob Guzzo, swimming's Don Easterling, soccer's George Tarantini, cross-country and track and field coach Rollie Geiger, and gymnastics' Mark Stevenson, all who built championship programs after they were hired by Casey. And he didn't just improve NC State athletics. He helped change the games and the championships we know today. Among those achievements, putting together the first nationwide syndicated broadcast for college basketball in 1973, getting the dunk reinstated to men's basketball after David Thompson was robbed of the opportunity to show all of his enormous basketball talent. Casey made it his cause to expand the NCAA tournament. It was the jolt the sport needed to grow into the March Madness we know today.
He's done so much for our program, and he did it behind the scenes a lot of times too. You didn't hear about him a whole lot.
And he would stand by the coaches. When you really had a problem and an issue, you could go to Willis, and Willis would back you.
Willis meant more to NC State athletics than anybody that in my memory.
No administrator in our school's history more deserving than Mr. Willis Casey for this Hall of Fame.
He was NC, and still is NC State athletics.
Casey retired in 1986 as the school's second longest serving athletics director. The Willis R. Casey Aquatic Center at Carmichael Gymnasium was named in his honor in 1992. And his imprint on the Wolfpack athletics program remains strong today.